Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and welcome back to this next video. And this is the second video on the differences between the normal cells and in the cancer cells. In the last video, I've told you that the normal cells, they are under the cell cycle control system by using the cyclins, the CDKs, and the ubiquitin proteasome system. While the cancer cells, they are not under the cell cycle control system, thereby their division is abnormal. These normal cells, they are actually removed by the process of the apoptosis, by the formation of the apoptotic bodies, and by doing so there is no damage to the surrounding tissue. When you talk about the cancer cells, they usually follow the necrosis, and because of the necrosis there is inflammation, and this inflammation actually is responsible for the uncontrolled release of the cell materials which damage the surrounding tissue. Then I've told you that these normal cells, they only divide when there is signal, and when the signal is over, they do not divide. But these cancer cells, they keep on dividing even if the signal is over. So in this particular video, I want to focus on some other differences between the normal cells and in the cancer cells. When you talk about these normal cells, during the process of the differentiation, they achieve distinct shapes and functions. But when you talk about these cancer cells, they divide so quickly that they do not get a chance to go on for the process of the differentiation. Thereby, their structure and functions are very different than the normal cells. In this particular chart, you can see the major differences in the shapes and the functions of the normal cells and in the cancer cells. So if these are the normal cells, you can see they are dividing in a very regulated manner. But when you talk about these cancer cells, many cells, they continue to grow and divide without the process of the differentiation and without assuming any proper shape and hence function. If you compare the shapes and if you see the variations in the shape and size of the normal cells and in the cancer cells, they are very obvious in these particular images. Now these normal cells, they usually have a very small nucleus. So if you talk about the ratio, so in the normal cells, the ratio of nucleus to cytoplasm is actually about 1:1.6 or 1:4. But these cancer cells, they have got a very large nucleus, and the cytoplasm to the nucleus ratio in most of the cases is 1:1. These have a very larger nucleus, thereby their shape is very different than their normal counterparts. When you talk about the normal cells during the replication, or when you talk about the number of the chromosomes, these are very well arranged in the normal cells, and they are very poorly arranged, or they are very disorganized in these cancer cells. And in most of the time, you see polyploidy in the cancer cells as compared to the diploid nature when you talk about the normal cells of the human beings. These normal cells, they actually have very clear boundaries. So when you talk about these cancer cells, the clusters of the cell, they do not have a very clear boundary, and you can see these very clearly in these images. So these are the differences in the shapes and the size variations between the normal cells and in the cancer cells. Another important difference between the normal cells and in the cancer cell is that these normal cells, they follow a phenomenon which is known as the contact inhibition, while these cancer cells, they do not follow the phenomena of the contact inhibition. So what actually is contact inhibition? Now this contact inhibition, that is actually a regulatory mechanism that is present in the normal cells, and the function of this regulatory mechanism is to keep the cell growing into a single layer, or you can say into a monolayer. So if you provide plenty of the available substrate space to these normal cells, they are going to replicate rapidly and they are going to move freely. And this process of free movement and the rapid replication, it continues until the cells occupy the entire substratum. So when the whole of the substratum that has been occupied, at this point the normal cells, they are going to stop replication, or you can say they are going to stop replication because the cells, they are coming in contact with each other, thereby the term contact inhibition. So the normal cells, they follow the contact inhibition. The normal, the cancer cells, they do not follow the contact inhibition. What this means is that the cancer cells, they are not going to grow in the monolayer. If you see these images, so when you talk about these normal cells, they've got these specialized proteins which are known as the E-cadherins. And because of these E-cadherins, when these cells, they are going to proliferate or they are going to divide, they are going to grow in the monolayer. When there is problem, when there is loss of the E-cadherins or when there is mutation in these E-cadherin proteins, what happens is that these cancer cells, then they are going to grow in these multilayers. As you can see over here, they are growing on the top of each other. And in most of the cancer cells, you see the loss of functions or of the E-cadherins, or there is mutation in the E-cadherin proteins. Thereby, these cancer cells, they do not follow the phenomena of the contact inhibition. Another important difference between the normal cell and the cancer cells is that these normal cells, they actually remains in place in your body because they are going to stick to the basement membrane, and because of the presence of the extracellular matrix, the normal cells in the body, they are going to occupy a particular position in the body. When you talk about these cancer cells, these cancer cells, they start spreading to other parts of the body. For example, if there is a cancer that develops in the lungs, they have the ability to spread into the liver. And if the cancer is present in the lungs and it spread into the livers, this is known as the metastatic lung cancer and not the liver cancer, because the primary tumor that was present in the lung and it has spread from the lungs into the liver, thereby it is known as the metastatic lung cancer and not the liver cancer. Now what happens is that, as I've told you, that the normal cells, they are being placed in a particular position in the body by the help of the basement membrane, a particular protein structure, and the extracellular matrix, again the polymer of the proteins. What happens is that these cancer cells, they are going to go for mutations, and because of the mutation, they are going to produce two particular type of the enzyme. One is known as the type 4 collagenases, and these type 4 collagenases, they are going to get rid of the basement membrane. So these are responsible, these enzymes are responsible for the breakdown of the type 4 collagen, which is present in the basement membrane. Thereby, they are removed from their normal place. Secondly, they are going to produce these specialized enzymes, which are known as the metalloproteinases, and these metalloproteinases, then they are responsible for the breakdown of the extracellular matrix. And when the cancer cells, they get rid of the basement membrane and the extracellular matrix, they are going to spread to other parts of the body, like from the lungs into the liver. Now, if you talk about the spread or this metastasis, as you can see over here, and this yellow one, this one is the primary tumor. That means this is the tumor, the origin of the tumor, and it has spread to the other parts of the body, as you can see these white spots over here. And in most of the cases, like 40% of the variation in the metastatic distribution is due to the flow, because these cells, they are going to enter into the blood or into the lymphatic system, and because of their entry into the blood and into the lymphatic system, they are going to spread from their primary location to the other parts of the body. So this one will be the primary tumors, and all of the following, they will be the secondary tumors. So we will continue the discussion in the next video. So if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and share it with your friends.